Hi, everyone. This week, I'm going to talk a little bit more about what's happening with recession risk. It's getting a lot of media attention right now, but we're seeing some of the leading indicators of an upcoming recession start to blink yellow. The 10-year versus the 2-year treasury rate has inverted. In other words, the 2-year treasury is paying a higher yield than the 10-year treasury. And that is a commonly known indicator of an upcoming recession within the next 24 months. In a nutshell, a yield curve inversion means that investors want a higher yield for short-term debt, and that implies that there's more economic risk over the short term. Regardless, most economists currently agree that the next recession will be moderate, or very mild actually, compared to the last one we had. So will we face a recession in the next 18 to 24 months? The answer is maybe. There's a lot of indicators that are still very strong. We're adding about 2 million jobs a year right now. Core retail sales is growing by about 3.8%. Wage growth is good. It's right around 3%. Disposable income is at an all-time high. People are creating households. There are a lot of indicators still pointing to positive territory. So a recession is not a foregone conclusion, but it is a rising risk. And from an investor's perspective, it's time to get ready. Every investor has to have a strategy. Now, that strategy could be to hold everything and not change anything. That strategy could be to change out part of a portfolio. It could be to buy, it could be to sell. The point is, it doesn't really matter what the strategy is, but it should be something proactive. It should be something that has been decided upon rather than something that is a default. We recommend that every investor assess every asset in their current portfolio and determine what should be held through the next downturn. You have to consider economic, market, and asset risk relative to the overall real estate strategy. But when people are thinking about their portfolio, they often think too narrowly. They're replacing the same property type in the same city. They say, oh, I'm going to sell an apartment in this city. How do I replace it with another apartment in the same city? There are a wide range of assets and a variety of markets to choose from. Each has different risk factors and different yields and different upside. Yields can range from about 4% for the highest quality assets in major metros, particularly for apartments, all the way up to the 9% range for independent hotels in smaller markets. Assets such as single-tenant properties with long-term leases to high credit companies can have significantly less risk in a recessionary climate. Other types of properties with strong underlying demand drivers, such as healthcare services and medical office, face less risk. Manufactured housing properties also tend to have less volatility during downturns. That said, now is an excellent time to consider portfolio diversification. You have to look across markets and across property types to sustain a portfolio yield during a downturn. You reduce your risk by being in multiple places with multiple property types. Marcus Millichap is uniquely positioned to help investors move capital between markets and property types. We have offices in virtually every major metro across the country, and we have currently listed assets of virtually every major property type all over the country. So it's a real opportunity for you to consider what you want to own, where you want to own it, and how you want to position your capital for the next cycle.